Hello and welcome to Craft with Sarah. In this video, I'm going to show you how to upload SVG files into Cricut Design Space. This works for all different types of Cricut cutting machine. If you've got a silhouette or a scan and cut machine instead, then head to craftwithsarah.com/help, choose your type of machine on the screen, and then you'll be able to find specific instructions for your type of machine and software. But if you've got a Cricut, you're already in the right place. So without any further ado, let's get started at seeing how to upload these SVG files. First things first, you'll need to choose an SVG that you want to make and download it from wherever it is that you found it. If you're using a Craft with Sarah SVG file, these will download as a zip folder. A zip folder is an easy way for me to give you multiple different files all contained in one easy download link. You'll need to unzip this folder before you can upload the SVG. On a Windows computer, find the zip folder. It will probably be in your downloads folder. Right click on it and press extract all. Choose somewhere to save it and then press extract. You can see I've now got a copy of that folder, only this time it doesn't end in .zip in that file name and it doesn't have the zip down the picture. That shows that this is the unzipped version. If you're using a Mac, you can just double click on the zip folder to unzip it. If you're using a mobile device such as a phone or tablet, whether that's on iOS or Android, head to craftwithsarah.com/unzip for a separate video on how to unzip on your particular device. Let's take a little look in the folder. If you're using one of my newer SVGs or one of the older designs that I have refactored, you'll see a lot of folders in here, all with a different number at the start. My team and I have been working really hard over the last few months to reformat all of our older designs so that they are easier to make in a wider range of cutting machine softwares, as well as for laser machines, sublimation printers, printing with just a regular color printer, and even cutting by hand. You'll know if you're looking at one of those reformatted designs because you'll see all of these folders with all these numbers. Don't worry, I'll show you exactly which one you'll need for your machine. If you're using a Craft with Sarah design and you've unzipped it and you don't see all of those folders with the numbers on, don't worry, that just means you're using an older design that we haven't got around to reformatting yet. We're hoping to get them all done by the end of this year, but it is taking a lot longer than we thought it was going to, but we'll get there. If you are using one of those older designs, you'll probably find that after you've unzipped the folder, it looks more like this instead. Rather than all of those other folders inside, there are just a few separate files. If you're looking for the SVG file, that will be the one that starts SVG in the file name. If you're looking for the DXF for the free version of Silhouette Studio, that's the one that starts DXF. Next, let's open up our cutting machine software to get the files uploaded. Next, open up Cricut Design Space. First, I'll show you how to do it on the desktop or computer version of Design Space, and then later on in this video, we'll see how to do the same thing on the mobile app version. So if you're using a tablet or a mobile phone, that's the version you'll need. On a computer or laptop, open up Cricut Design Space, and then press the Canvas button over on the top left to start a new project. To upload an SVG into Design Space, press the Upload button on the left of the screen. Then click the green button that says Upload Image. You can then either click Browse to find the file on your computer, or you can drag and drop it in. Make sure you choose the unzipped version of your download folder. If you're using one of my newer designs that's got all of these numbered folders inside, I've made things super easy for you as a Cricut user because there's a folder in there called 01 Cricut version, and that is the one you're going to need. Double click in there and then there'll be one file in there and it will start SVG-01 in the file name. So if you're not sure about which one to use, look for the folder that says 01 Cricut version and then the file will always start SVG-01. Click and drag that in and it will look like this with all the pieces one on top of the other. Don't worry that it looks like a completed picture. It will still load in with all of the layers or pieces separate. Press continue. On this screen, if you want to, you can give the image a name, some tags to help you find it later, and a folder to save it in. But I'm going to skip all that and just go straight ahead and press upload. It'll take a few seconds, but then the SVG will appear on your project. If you want to see all those different layers, you can click the arrow next to it in the layers panel, and then you can see all of the pieces in there that make up this design. For further tutorials on how to do things like customize the colors in a design, remove layers or adapt layers to use more or less sheets of cardstock, or to remove patterns that maybe you don't want to cut, and even for a full tutorial on how to turn your SVG from loading it into the project into the perfectly sized design for whatever it is you want to make, and a full process on how to cut everything from different colours of cardstock with your Cricut machine, head to craftwithzara.com/help, choose Cricut from the list of machine options, and then that will list out all of those tutorials I've just mentioned, as well as lots more. Before we finish up with the computer version of Design Space, I also want to show you how it looks if you're uploading one of my older designs that I haven't reformatted into that new folder structure yet. So I'll click on this one and hit the delete key on my keyboard, go back to upload, and then upload image. So for this design, you see I don't have all of those folder names. Instead, I've just got files listed out here. If this is what you're seeing on your screen, the file you're looking for is the one that starts SVG. It might be in capital letters or it might be in lowercase. It doesn't matter. Just make sure you choose the one that starts SVG. So I'll click and drag that in. And again, it should look like a completed picture. If yours looks different and you see all the pieces next to each other on the screen instead, that means you've accidentally uploaded the wrong file. So if that's the case, just click cancel here, try again, and make sure you choose the one that starts SVG. Then it's just exactly the same. You can press continue and then upload, and it will put the design on, and then you can see the layers or the pieces by clicking that arrow. So that's how to upload SVG files into Cricut Design Space on a computer or laptop. Now let's take a look at how it works on a tablet or a mobile device. First, you need to download the SVGs and then save them to your iPad or your phone or other kind of device. I've saved mine in my On My iPad folder, so I'll click the little icon on the top left, then press On My iPad. You can see the two zip folders here. For my iPad, all I need to do is tap on those zip folders to unzip them. So I'll do that now, first with the fairy door and then the seahorse. Let's take a look inside, starting with the fairy door. You can see that folder structure exactly the same as it looked on the desktop version. And again, with the seahorse, that's got all those files in there too. So now I've got those unzipped, I can open up the Cricut Design Space app. It might ask you to sign in if it's been a while since you last used the app. So I'm going to press sign in on the bottom, and then in the little box that pops up, press continue. Enter your email and password and then press sign in. After you've signed in, press the canvas button on the top right of the screen. That will take you to a new project. Press the upload button along the bottom and then browse files. Go into where you saved the unzipped versions. For me, that's in my On My iPad section, so I'll click into there. And then first we'll do the fairy door. Choose the unzipped version and then the folder that says 01 Cricut version, then select the file inside. You have to give the image a name, so let's go for fairy door and then press upload on the top right of the screen. Once that's uploaded, it will insert the design straight onto your project. To see all the pieces that are in it, press the layers button along the bottom. Now you can see all of those pieces that make up the design. Let's have a look at the seahorse design too to show you where to find the files on that one. Once again, I'll tap on upload along the bottom and then browse files. I'll find the files in my On My iPad folder and then choose the seahorse design this time, and then the file that starts SVG in the file name. It should look like this with all the pieces one on top the other. Give it a name and press upload. And then the SVG gets magically loaded onto your canvas, ready for you to start crafting. Once again, you can see all of the pieces by pressing layers in the layers panel. And there you have it, how to upload SVGs on the mobile app version of Cricut Design Space. I hope you enjoyed this video on how to upload SVG files into Cricut Design Space. If you did, please give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel for loads more Cricut tutorials and free SVGs. To find all of the other Cricut videos in this series, head to craftwithsarah.com/help, click on the Cricut option, and then they will all show up for you. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!